If you would like to fly this particular great aircraft after the show today or any time throughout the course of the year, the Dorsey Town Distress, the trusted crew, they are located on the flight line. You can see a big tent. It's close to where he will park the aircraft. And there his crew members will tell you about all of the information you need to do it here this afternoon after the show, or concerning any time throughout the course of the year. By the way, another great story of this aircraft. You might have seen the shark's teeth on the side of the hallway. That was put there, it is said, to intimidate the Japanese. Well, the story goes back even before that. Because the airplane did not have particularly good air-to-air combat, it was relegated for the most part to air-to-ground operations. However, before World War II, before the U.S. got into World War II, General Claire Chennault, on behalf of the Chinese who were fighting the Japanese, got together a group of civilian, we can call them mercenary pilots, known as the Flying Tigers. They were upset to put that shark's tooth on the column of the airplane to intimidate the enemy. However, if you go back in history, you can see that the British actually had that same symbol at the nose of their aircraft as they attacked Brown Tigers.
Did he already do the banana passes?
No, not yet. I think that's at last.
Okay. Well, I didn't know if he was...
aircraft. So that's all a bit of history. If you want to ever see a great...
Finishing
movie,
up.